Welcome back to Physical Chemistry on Catalyst University. My name is Kevin Tokoph. Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. All right, in the previous video in this playlist on real gas behavior, we talked extensively about the hard shell model. So in one of those videos, I went over the theory of it. We discussed where the new piece in the equation comes from. Remember, the hard shell model accounts for now repulsive forces, so electrostatic repulsion between two nuclei, so a nuclei of different atoms. And we have now an effective reduced volume available for these particles because of that electrostatic repulsion, and we have to account for that. We also did some practice problems in the following video. Now we're going to do an extension of the hard shell model, and this is what's called the van der Waals equation of state, or the van der Waals model. So first of all, here I have the hard shell model rewritten. So remember, it was nRT divided by the quantity V minus nB. Okay, where the denominator here is now the lowered effective volume. And we can also remember divide through both the top and the bottom by n, and we can get this in terms of molar quantities, where the hard shell model pressure is RT divided by the quantity molar volume minus B. All right, so mainly what we're going to focus on is we're going to focus on this first one where it's non-molar quantities, okay? Because this one right here accounts for the electrostatic repulsions. So what the van der Waals equation of state or model does is, in addition to accounting for electrostatic repulsions, it's now going to account for electrostatic attractions. Okay, so the way the van der Waals model works is it's going to use this term as is, but now we're going to add on another term. So let me first show you the form of the van der Waals equation of state we're going to work with. The van der Waals pressure now is equal to nRT divided by the quantity V minus nB. That's exactly the same as before, but now I have to subtract this thing off. So subtract A times n squared divided by V squared. Again, here n is the number of moles and it's squared, and then V is the volume, again squared in the denominator. Okay, and A right here, A is a constant, okay? A is the attractive constant. This is a constant you look up in a table. It's different for every molecule, but it accounts for the attractive forces, okay? And so, again, to find this, you just take A n squared divided by V squared. All right, so there's two things about this term, and these are going to be important as conceptual questions in physical chemistry. Just like B, A is always positive, always a positive number. N is moles, obviously positive, and you can't have a negative volume, so V is always positive. So this whole term right here is a positive number, okay, and it's subtracted off. So to answer the question as to why this attractive term is subtracted off, which would lower the pressure, I want to look at this blue particle right here. All right, so let's forget any attraction. This blue particle is just going to be by itself, okay, just by itself. That particle, let's say it's moving at this trajectory towards the wall, and we're going to consider the red line, right? It's going to move towards the wall, bounce off, and it's going to, here's the force vector for how it's moving off, how it's bouncing off the wall. So that particle is just going to hit the boundary and bounce off, and it's going to have some amount of force associated with it, all right? But now let's consider this blue particle is being attracted by these two purple particles. So again, these particles are not close enough to really consider repulsions, but they're at a distance where attraction is going to play a role. So the blue particle, as you can see here, is attracted toward these purple particles. Well, the blue particle may still move towards the boundary and it'll bounce off, but if there's a force that's pulling this blue particle towards the purple particles, it's not going to collide with as much force, and then you can see in this green vector, the force that it bounces off the boundary with is going to be much less. Okay, so the point here is when you've got other particles in the gas that are attracting a particle of interest, so there's attractive forces, then this particle of interest is not going to collide with as much force. And so if you account this now for all the particles in the gas, there's overall less force of collision. So all the collisions are going to have lowered force. And along the same argument, lower force means lower pressure. And so since A, N, and V are all positive, I need to subtract this off, this attractive force term. I need to subtract it off so that my overall pressure should actually go down. Okay, so again, the repulsive part, that'll make the pressure go up, but this attractive part will make the pressure go down. And how that pressure is going to relate to that of an ideal situation, an ideal gas, is going to depend on, is there more attractive forces or more repulsive forces? If you think about there being more repulsive forces than attractive forces, then the van der Waals pressure would be higher than that of an ideal gas. However, in the opposite case, if we have a case where there are more attractive forces than repulsive forces, then the resulting van der Waals pressure would actually be lower than that of an ideal gas. Okay, so the important thing about the van der Waals model or van der Waals equation of state is that it accounts for both repulsive and attractive forces. The repulsive part is the same part from the hard shell model, and this new minus an squared over v squared is your attractive component. And hopefully you understand now where it comes from. All right. And again, this A and B, they are both positive values. You have to look them up in the in a table or something, and they are both empirically determined. There's no way to derive these, so they have to be found experimentally. So now that we've discussed the theory behind the van der Waals equation of state, in the next video, we're going to do some practice problems with this. And it turns out there's actually a lot more types of problems you can see associated with the van der Waals model. For example, we'll do things like taking derivatives, simply calculating pressure, but you can also look at things like, are the attractive forces or repulsive forces more dominant? And to do that, you'll actually have to do an ideal gas calculation. So. Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. Thank you very much.